I found a thumb drive. Should I plug it in? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. One day I found a USB thumb drive and I plugged it into my computer. After that, I couldn't do most of the stuff on my computer. I couldn't open Help and Support Center, run MSN, other installed programs, System Restore, Edge. Do I have malware or something of that sort? Yeah, I'll bet you do. In fact, it's not at all obvious, but plugging a random USB thumb drive into your machine can cause all sorts of havoc. And it gets worse because it might not even be a USB thumb drive. Let's look at what I'm talking about. So there's this, I'll call it an apocryphal story. I read it some time ago, but it boils down to this. As an experiment, some students left random thumb drives around a college campus, just in various places where you might seem to accidentally lose a thumb drive. What was on those thumb drives was malware. It was benign malware. It was malware that really did nothing more than communicate back to those students that, yep, this particular thumb drive had been plugged in. So it wasn't truly malicious, but it was, in a sense, malware, because it could have been anything. What they discovered was that over 50% of all of the thumb drives that they left scattered about had been, in fact, plugged in by unsuspecting users. Here's the problem. That benign malware could have been anything but benign. It could have been truly malicious malware. It could have been ransomware. It could have been basically anything. You're inviting unknown software to run on your machine. Now, one of the reasons that happens is this thing called AutoPlay. AutoPlay is the feature, you've probably seen it by now, where if you, in the old days, insert a CD or a DVD, nowadays when you plug in a USB drive, the system will say, hey, what do you want to do with this? It will ask you, what do you want me to do with this type of device? Do you want me to just open up File Explorer? Do you want me to run this program? Do you want me to do something else? In the worst case, it won't ask. It is possible, usually revolving around setup programs, where if you just plug in the USB drive, it'll start running a piece of software from that USB drive without asking. If that software happens to be malware, well, to put it bluntly, you're screwed. There's no way to know before you plug in the thumb drive that it doesn't have malware on it. The best way to think of it is exactly as if you had downloaded something unknown from the internet. That download could be anything. Before you run it, you want to check it to see if it's malicious software. And you usually do that by running your anti-malware tool on it. But with a USB thumb drive, you've got this chicken and egg. You need to connect it before being able to scan it. But once you connect it, it may automatically run software from the device. That's not good. There are two solutions to this problem. One, resist the temptation. Seriously, it's just not worth it. If you find a USB thumb drive lying around, throw it away. Discard it. There really isn't any easy way to erase what's on it without plugging it into something, and you don't know that plugging it into something isn't going to cause problems. The second solution is to turn off autoplay. So, let's do that. We're here in Windows 10. For the record, the companion article for this video shows this in Windows 11, but I wanted to show you here in Windows 10. If you just open up the Settings app and search for autoplay, you'll see that turn autoplay on or off is right there very quickly. Here I've got autoplay for all media and devices. It's currently turned on. I'm turning it off. That's all you have to do. Really, that's all you need to do. You should now be able to more or less safely plug something in order to do a scan on it. Honestly, it's still not worth it. I still wouldn't do it. And there's one more reason why. It might not be a USB thumb drive. It may look like a USB thumb drive, but it might not be one. There are devices that, as it turns out, I believe you could just purchase on Amazon, that are called USB killers. They live up to their name. They are designed to do physical damage to your computer when plugged in. Now, how much physical damage they can do depends on the computer, depends on how well-built and well-protected that computer is. But what they end up doing is they end up having a battery inside, not a USB stick, but a battery that has a really, really high charge. What they can then do is send a really, really high jolt of electricity through the USB connector. Depending on your system, that can ruin that USB connector. It can destroy all the USB connectors. It can destroy your motherboard. Heck, in the really worst case, it could cause your machine to catch on fire. That, if for no other reason, is a great reason to never plug something into your machine that you aren't completely 100% certain of. Yeah, USB killers are rare. It's way more likely you're going to find a thumb drive lying around than you are one of these malicious devices. But you need to know that they exist. And especially if you are someone who could be targeted or who hangs out with people who could be targeted. Maybe you work at a government agency. You're not a target, but somebody there might be. Just don't do it. It's not worth it. Turn off autoplay for extra safety. Whenever possible, avoid plugging unknown and unrecognized USB devices into your system. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/3319. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.